And Hayes bats him at 113. Takes a leg, throws him down. Oh, he's got him. He's going to get it. It's a pin. Knights win the match. Now here's Ryan, top seat. Ryan takes the leg, takes the arm, throws him down, rolls him over. Is he going to get it? Yes! Knights win. It all comes down to this. It's Jackson. Jackson, oh, he gets thrown down. Oh, no, Knights are in trouble. Jackson flips up, throws him over, gets him back. He gets the pin. Knights win!
I got a feeling.
What's up, Knight Nation? State Tournament Eve with Inside the Lair with Kirby and Blair.
1, 2, 3. Good afternoon, lords and ladies of the castle. It is Wednesday, March the 1st, 2017, and you are watching Inside the Lair with Kirby and Blair. I'm Blair, he's Kirby. Kirby, do you wake up from your nap now?
I had a good feeling after I took my nap. I got a vision.
You got a good vision.
I saw
there
it clearly, and I got a good feeling going in tomorrow.
XL Energy Center is where it's going to happen tomorrow, 11 a.m., your Knight wrestling team. First round of the tournament, they do it all in one day. 11 a.m. quarterfinal against Zumbrota Mazeppa, a team we know very well. And it's time to do a little cougar hunting there.
Oh, yeah.
This is going to be a rematch and a bit of a revenge since the Knights lost a duel earlier in the year. But we things have changed a little bit, and it would not shock anyone if the Knights got through that. If they win, they'll take on either top seed Frazee or Sibley East at 1 p.m., and then if they win that, and they only lost to Frazee by a little bit up in Bemidji, if they win that, curve, 7 p.m. championship match, and they'll be going for the repeat.
Well, let's get past ZM,
yes,
first.
Absolutely.
ZM's going to be tough. It's going to be match by match. It's going to be so intense, and I can't wait to see our guys battle through intensity, nerves, all of that stuff that goes in with competing at a high level. I think they're battle-tested, they're ready to go, and I think we're going to do it.
I can't bet against this team. This is a really strong team, well-coached team.
Well-coached.
And they have that experience that ZM, you know, they weren't there last year. These Knight guys, they know what's expected. They're on their way up there now. They're going to get to the hotel. They're going to get ready, and they're going to be ready to go 11 a.m. tomorrow. Lots of people coming up from Kenyon Wanamingo. Kids here at school are psyched up about it. This is going to be a really fun weekend for the Knights. And it doesn't end with Thursday. Friday and Saturday, we have six individuals who made it to the state tournament by finishing either first or second in the section. Jaron Mattson, Tyler Ryan, Seth Brossard, and Bradley Kish all won their section title, along with Logan Quam and Jesse Jackson, who finished second. So all of them will be in the state individual tournament at their respective weight classes. Mattson and Ryan seated number one, the favorites to win the individual title.
They deserve it. Those kids work so hard, they're so talented, and they kind of have an edge where they know they're the best one on the mat at that time. And that little edge just gives them a little bit of an advantage over the other team, or the other person, I should say. So best of luck to Jaron and Tyler for getting seated first, and I should say congratulations to that. But best of luck to all six of our boys. Pretty special. And, you know, ZM, they got seated ahead of us. They also have six guys going to the state tournament as well.
Yeah, and in Cass and Manorville, too, up in AA, they're the favorites. So think of the wrestling prowess we have just in this little area
unreal,
of ours.
Unreal.
Let's switch to girls basketball. Good luck to those wrestlers.
Yep.
And the girls basketball team won their first round match last Thursday, beating Cannon Falls, a team that knocked them out of the playoffs last year. They won that one 64-55 over the Bombers. Closer than the earlier season meeting, but still a good win for Coach Lurkin and team. And that advanced them to last night's game at Rochester at the Civic Center, 4-5 matchup where they took on Pine Island. Pine Island ahead at half, and then all of a sudden, this Knight team clamped down defensively, and the shots started to fall for the Knights.
First of all, in the playoffs, it doesn't matter how well you play, as long as you have one more point than the other team at the end of the game. And so far, we've had two victories. both games, though, we started out slow.
Yeah.
It took us a while to get going. And like you said, against Pine Island, we didn't have the lead at half. We were down 6, 24 to 18. But I kind of had a feeling that we were going to make a push. We didn't have any threes in the first half. They had 4 threes, including some banks.
Yeah.
And eventually, right in the second half, Marquand scores 2 quick buckets. Our defensive pressure and the full court pressure starts picking up. We get some easy baskets. Megan Flung hit 2 huge threes.
Yeah.
And Savannah Blisa kind of woke up too. So Marquand led us with 28 points, her season average. She has carried us these first 2 games. And interestingly enough, the Bulldogs of Plainview Elgin Millville, the top seed,
yeah,
got beat 54-52 last night to 8th seeded Winona Cotter. And so the Knights, who they thought they'd be playing the Bulldogs if they won, they will actually be taking on the Cotter team.
Yeah, Cotter. Not that Cotter.
What are you doing?
Not that Cotter.
Not that Cotter.
Not welcome back, Cotter. Winona Cotter.
Winona Cotter, the Ramblers.
And that's going to be 11 o'clock in the morning,
yeah,
down at Rochester in the auditorium. Mm. And you know, great matchup. A weird time. And that's going to be a challenge for both teams to get them ready for that. And you can't discount Cotter,
no,
because even though Horshack and Epstein and Barbarino aren't going to come to play for them, this is a team that beat the top seed number 2 team in the state.
Can't take them lightly. I know we've played them before. We beat them. Marquand actually set a KW record for points in a game with 41 that game. And that was, I believe, over Christmas break. But we're 2 months from that.
Yeah.
Things have changed. Cotter has a really good score. I believe she might be an 8th grader, the coach's kid, or she's been playing since 8th grade, one of the two. But she is very tough. We're going to have to play better than what we have to get this done. But we're 2 games away from the state tournament. And on the other side is the Eagles from Rochester Leeward, and they will be taking on the Hayfield Vikings. So if we can get past Winona Cotter, we'll be taking on one of these two teams.
Friday, March 10th.
Next Friday, March 10th. I think it's a 6 o'clock start.
6 o'clock game down at the Civic Center.
Yeah.
And that's going to be a fantastic thing to see. And, you know, I was thinking about this on my drive down here, Kerb. The size school we have, think about this. We had football and volleyball both got as far as the section championship game. Wrestling's at state, 1 game away for the girls' basketball team. To think we have 4 teams in the first 2 seasons of the year, I mean, that not many schools can do that, and that's a testament to the athletes and coaches that we have here.
And we're hoping some of our spring sports are highly competitive,
yeah,
too, this year. So we've got it going on at KW, and I hope the young kids who are watching, they're getting juiced up inside. They're getting jacked up. They can't wait to get out there and compete, too, when they get a little older.
Marquand, all-star.
Yeah, all-star.
Named the all-star team.
Unbelievable.
And you know what? I haven't seen her play a lot, but she's so smooth and so smart on the court. She's a great basketball player. Coach Lurkin has been very lucky to have her in the fold for so many years.
She's so effortless in,
yes,
how she scores. She can score in every single way, from deep, mid-range jumpers, pull-up jumpers. When you think she's going to attack, she'll just stop on a dime and shoot a nice jump shot, pull-up
very
jumper.
Very disciplined.
And then she takes to the rack and plays great defense, too. And she's so quick when she gets that ball, she's right past it. It's like Speedy Gonzalez. Anyways, speaking of Coach Lurkin, I had a chance to catch up with him after last night's big win. Here with Coach Lurkin of the KW girls basketball team. Impressive win last night. We were halfway to our goal of section champions. And we started slow last night, again, after starting slow against Cannon Falls. What was the difference in the halves last night?
Yeah, you know, first half, it was tough. We started out, we had some great looks. I think we missed our first 5 or 6 shots from the field, which was tough because we weren't able to set up our press.
Mm-hmm.
That's something that we like to do a lot. And I thought the second half we did a much better job of attacking the basket, getting to the free throw line, which allowed us to get into our pressure, and then that kind of opened up the game for us.
And we, you know, looking at the halftime stats, Quam had 12 points. Our next closest scorer was Morgan Burrow with 3 points. And I was finally good in the second half to see Flummer hit a few big threes, Savannah start to pour some points into. And like you said, our defensive pressure really turned up, and I think that was the difference of the game. Now we're playing Cotter on Saturday at 11 a.m. Give us some info about Cotter.
Well, it's kind of interesting because we played Cotter once this year, and it was actually at the auditorium, so it'll be a rematch in the same gym. But just from watching them last night against Penn, they're definitely not the same team that we saw earlier this season. They've really improved. They played great defense. They shoot the ball well. They have a really good senior point guard, Gabby Bolin, and it's going to be a tough matchup for us.
Okay, and if we happen to be fortunate enough to earn and deserve victory against Cotter, we'll be taking on either Rochester, Leeward, or Hayfield. 2 very tough teams. Anything about those 2 teams?
Yeah, you know, that'll be the game right after us, Saturday at 1 p.m., I believe, and that's going to be a great game. Those are two quality teams. We played Hayfield twice and had a couple good games but weren't able to knock them off, and then we also lost to Lourdes on the road, so they're both quality opponents.
But I think we got something going for us. I believe we got the best guards in the whole tournament, so best of luck to you on Saturday. I hope we get it done.
Thanks, bud.
Our thanks to Coach Lurkin. Good luck to them Saturday morning against Cotter. Boys basketball lost their last two regular season games of the year, 68-53 to Casa Manorville, and then 69-42 in the last home game to Waterville. And that got them the playoff seed of 15, and they are going to match up with St. Charles tomorrow night down in St. Charles. St. Charles, a very good team. I thought they should be the one seed, a better record than Caledonia. And I don't know what they were thinking in that coaches meeting, but I think the Saints from St. Charles are the team to beat in this section, and maybe the Knights can pull a shocker.
The Saints are tough. Watched them a few times last year, and I know they might be a little different, but their core is the same. And playing in their gym, they will try to speed us up and make poor decisions, quicker decisions that we want to have to make. So we need to maintain our composure. We need to take some time off the clock and shorten the game. But the biggest thing is we got to limit turnovers. Yeah, we can't absolutely just keep giving them extra possessions and us having empty possessions, if you will. So best of luck to our
good
guys.
Good luck to them.
It's unfortunate timing with the state tournament.
That's the hard thing, yeah.
But, you know, the girls were in the same spot last year.
You got a job to do. You got to do it. Hey, so it's part of life.
Let's go get it.
The one thing that happened last weekend here at KW, the play, Sweeney Todd.
Excellent.
We saw it last Thursday. Phenomenal job. The great cast, great crew, great directing. I was thoroughly entertained by it.
Coach Hawkinson, I should say, Director Hawkinson, he does a great job getting these kids prepared. We had a big snowstorm come in, and the kids were able to perform it to the student body a day earlier than they were planning to do that, and they nailed it. Now, the lead character, Hunter Stanky, so good in my opinion. Just love watching him do what he does.
Talk about effortless. He is on so every single time I've seen him perform.
But they have so much courage to get up there in front of their peers and put on a play. So bravo to you guys. And then earlier this week, Blair,
this was phenomenal.
Our fine arts is doing an excellent job. Claire Larson and Stephanie Schumacher, who is getting assisted right now from Jesse Belke.
Yep.
With the choir position, they got superior ratings at the large group contest this week, and it was held here at KW, and our musicians are so talented. They work so hard and put so much time into practicing their craft. It's unreal.
And some of the highest marks of the entire contest that day, and someone that a long time ago did that in high school for choir, knowing it takes a lot. They just don't give these out like free candy canes. This is a hard mark to get, and year in and year out, we get them.
They're looking for any little imperfections that we might have, and we got two superiors, which is excellent. And I hope my girls someday can have Claire Larson as a director and Stephanie Schumacher as choir director, too. So I hope they continue to stick around KW.
I might even open and enroll my kids because it's such a great program. Who knows? Finally, trap shooting team, important info. If you want to shoot this year competitively for the Knights, you've got to get your stuff in by March 10th. Register. And this, we've talked about this program before. This is a wonderful addition to the KW family. This is a great activity. Boys and girls, this is something that everyone can be involved in.
The popularity continues to grow, and the kids are having so much fun doing it. We live in rural, you know, Minnesota. Yeah.
God's
it's something
country.
That a lot of our kids and students really love to do. So let's try it competitively. Yeah.
Get out
so
there.
If you have any questions about it, come and talk to me, and I'll hook you up with Coach Larry Walker or Shane Lundy. So I think that's it.
Yeah, well, good luck, Knights. Be safe up there. Make good decision, Knight Nation.
Represent us well.
Yeah. Exactly. And you know what, Kirby, you get some sleep this weekend, but you got to cheer for the Knights. What do you say to the football team? Say it to the fans right now.
All gas, no brakes. We'll see you next time. It's Kirby.
I'm Blair.
It's Inside the Lair.
Out.
Peace.